The Merryweather Steam Fire Engine is a popular exhibit with visitors to Carrickfergus Museum. For the modern viewer, looking at the striking apparatus transports us to a bygone world of horse-drawn vehicles, when technology of the day was very different, but no less ingenious. And in fact, it is more familiar than you think. The fire engine was presented to the town of Carrickfergus in 1908 by Colonel Craig, a great benefactor of the town. In 1903, Woodburn Weaving Factory had caught fire, causing damage amounting to £25,000. The Belfast Fire Brigade attended the scene, taking an hour to cover the 11 miles. It was later this same year that Colonel Craig presented the council with a manual fire engine and fire escape for the use of the inhabitants and neighbourhood. This manual engine is shown here in the town hall courtyard, then occupied by the Antrim Artillery. The original fire engine house can be seen just behind. The Fire Brigade Committee first met on the 1st of February 1904 and notes the fees payable to the men. The rule book of the Fire Brigade was published in May of that year and states that the council is responsible for providing each member with the following equipment: a tunic, helmet, overalls, trousers, belt, hatchet, lifeline, and lantern, all of which must be kept in good condition. The uniforms cost £5 per man. The first fire the new brigade attended was at Woodburn Factory. In May 1908, the manual engine was exchanged for the Merryweather Steam Fire Engine. It was purchased second-hand at a cost of £176, again with the assistance from Colonel Craig. Here, the whole brigade can be seen outside the YMCA in their uniforms, including their ornate brass helmets, one of which remains at Carrickfergus Museum. Before the first motorised fire engines were seen in the early 20th century, the horse-drawn steam engine was the most efficient fire appliance. A coal fire heated up the boiler hot enough to produce steam to propel the water. All the machinery was mounted on a horse-drawn sprung carriage with four steel-tired wooden wheels. Merryweather and Sons made a wide variety of designs of horse-drawn land steam fire engines from around 1862 into the 20th century. The earliest ones had horizontal steam cylinders and pump cylinders. The driver sat at the front on his own seat guiding the horses, and the other firemen sat on the hose box facing outwards. Some steam fire engines had a gong on the underside of the driver's footplate, which was sounded to clear a way through the traffic. But in the case of the Carrickfergus engine, the firemen would either have had to shout, "Hey, hey, hey," or blow a trumpet or a bugle. But how did the steam pump engine actually work? STEM volunteer and marine engineer Graham Knowles took a good look at the museum's fire engine and instantly recognised the technology at work here, as it remains virtually the same today. The firefighting part of the engine is split into two main parts: the boiler and steam pump. The boiler has a firebox at the bottom, similar to a wood burning stove you may have at home. The fire heats water in the boiler, just like a kettle heats water. The boiler is above the firebox, but in this case, the steam that would have come out of a kettle spout is trapped in the boiler. The boiler has three main safety features: two water gauge glasses and two pressure gauges. Water gauge glasses show how much water is in the boiler. Pressure gauges show how much steam pressure we have. And around towards the other side, at the back of the boiler, there are two safety valves which would release the steam if we got too much pressure. There are two of each safety devices, a second one just in case the first doesn't work. This is the same arrangement on modern boilers. If the water level in the boiler was too low, the boiler could overheat and burn out, leading to an expensive repair. The pressure gauges are to monitor the pressure of the steam in the boiler. If the pressure in the boiler went too high and the safety valves didn't let the pressure out, the boiler could blow up. Very dangerous. At the back is the steam-driven pump. Once the boiler built up sufficient pressure, the steam would be allowed into the steam pump. The steam pump has two main parts. A steam engine at the top, which turns steam pressure from the boiler into movement. Then a water pump at the bottom, that is turned by the steam engine above. The water pump delivered water to a fire hose that was connected at the back of the pump. The water pump could also be used to top up the water in the boiler as the water was used up. The fire brigade also employed pumpers, local men who worked the pumping mechanism on the engine when they arrived at a fire. Committee minutes from 1906 show expenses listed for 50 pumpers at a total cost of £10. Here is the fire brigade in action in Market Place during its early days. The fire station was at Northgate, though they had to go and get the horses first. They were supplied by a Mr. Edward Davy and kept nearby. In the early years, the brigade was only called out a few times per year, and rapid technological advancements meant that the steam-powered engine in Carrickfergus was virtually obsolete by the end of the First World War. The Belfast Brigade was entirely motorised by 1915 and could attend fires in Carrickfergus almost as soon as the local crew could assemble their equipment and respond. As a result, the Carrickfergus Brigade was disbanded in the 1920s. The engine lived at Carrickfergus Castle for many years, where we've been told it was climbed on by lots of children. It was restored and moved into the museum in 2004.